Blessed Holy Week, welcome to this time of prayer and meditation around the Word of God. We are happy that you have decided to join us on this journey through the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. A reading from the Gospel of John. Among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled. And what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The crowd answered him, "We have heard from the law that the Messiah remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man?" And Jesus said to them, "The light is with you for a little longer. Walk while you have the light, so that the darkness may not overtake you. If you walk in the darkness, you do not know where you are going. While you have the light, believe in the light, so that you may become children of light." After Jesus had said this, he departed and hid from them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Everything was becoming ready for Jesus to suffer the consequences of words and actions, especially now that he was already in Jerusalem. He has spent almost 3 years teaching and healing those in pain, challenging the religion of his people and living God's kingdom. Many witnessed his words and actions, some because of their faith in him, others to accuse him of some heresy, some others just out of curiosity. And after almost 3 years, Jesus continues to attract people around him. "I wish to see Jesus," ask some Greeks to Philip, the disciple. We don't know for sure what these tourists in Jerusalem are really looking for, or why specifically they want to see Jesus. How did they get to know about Jesus in the first place? Were they looking for the miracles and the visible signs that always attracted the multitudes? Were they looking instead for some kind of wisdom from this unique Jewish religious leader called Jesus? We don't know. But what we do know is that the only thing that they will be able to see this late in Jesus' life is the face of pain, suffering, and death. for sure not a nice spectacle. In the end, we prefer to think that suffering and death are not real, or that they don't exist. We throw them under the rug because it is too painful and too uncomfortable to face pain and suffering. And in our religious life, we prefer to hold on to the glorious, risen, full in light Jesus over the suffering and dying one. But we are not allowed to choose during Holy Week. If we really wish to see Jesus, we will get what we see. Life and death, pain, sorrow, and risen life from the cross, bleeding wounds and an open tomb, a crown of thorns and a garden of new life. All at once, no way to choose, all at once in these 7 days. In this sanitized world in which we live, the experience of Holy Week can be uncomfortable and chaotic. But let's remember that in the midst of life and death, suffering and new life, we will be able to find not only Christ, but our own stories, all comprised in 7 days, just there in front of our eyes, for us to see what is possible in God, that death is not the only thing, that death is not the last thing, that life comes with its challenges, and that God is always present before, during, and after, forever. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the passion of your blessed Son you made an instrument of shameful death to be for us the means of life, grant us so to glory in the cross of Christ that we may gladly suffer shame and loss for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard good of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge of and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen.
Amen.
And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.